We can't give God a hand. Can we do that? Give the Lord a hand. Give the Lord a hand. It is good. It is good to be in the presence of God and all the people. We're going to sing and get out your way. I want to hear the word this morning.
Amen. Amen.
And we've been driving all the way from Charlotte. I born and raised in the DMV, graduated of the Governor's School of Performing Arts here. Product of the University of Bishop of Columbia. Yeah. And so the Lord called me into pastoring. I was an associate minister in Long, pastor in Long Grambling. I relocated to Charlotte to pastor a little more than 11 years ago. And when I left, everything was different. So we drove back this time. I had minister in Baltimore last night, so we have about half a voice left. But everything changed. It changed. I saw Ferris wheels over the window, wheels on the window. I said, all those hotels on there. I said, I've been like, oh, yeah, I don't know if I can afford to stay over there right now. I'm going to keep on driving. And I told a pastor, at first, this is poor preacher etiquette. Let me give you, do this for me. Stand up and give you a man of God. Dr. Rob, that's what I'm sorry for. He's a wonderful man of God. This is how I know he's a wonderful man of God. The kings, you know, when the Queen of Sheba came to see Solomon, she said the truth had been told because kings recognize certain things. Leaders recognize certain things. We were met at the front door and the folk hugged us and loved us and they were smiling at us. And I said, I'm in the right house. When you call the house of God, people smile at you. Let me tell you something. Charisma Magazine said over the Ark 15 years ago, people decide the first 5 seconds if they're coming back to your church. Amen. I will come back to this church.
Amen.
I feel love in the house of God. If you got the singer, those singers over here on the front. That is my. Can I be heard a little bit this morning? I do have a message. In theology, I understand he's an ask for order, but that's my man. Been to my studio, even his dad has gone on to be with the Lord, and we share that. Both my father's gone on to be with the Lord since I've had it. It's good to see you, and I did set you up because I'm without my alto, so I'm gonna sing a couple things, and I'm gonna put you on the spot, have you sing alto. We are deputizing you, deputizing you, honorary William Beckham friends. Sing today. All right. I'm almost there. Look at someone say, you're almost there.
I'm almost there.
2 days we're going to sing. I've been gone 13 years.
All right.
I lost 100 pounds.
All right.
Yeah. I ain't that guy no more. I ain't that guy no more. By God, I am this guy right now. The Bible said, asked the Lord, said, God, have I pleased you? She said, yeah. She said, the doctor told me I'm going to die next year this time, but can I have 20 more years? God said, yeah, I'll give you 20 more years.
Okay.
So she left out there, got her hair done, got her tummy tucked, and a year later, she died. She went to heaven. She said, God, don't you want to get me 20 more years? God said, oh, I didn't even recognize you. Come on, Joshua. I promise you, I'll get out of your way. We got BCDs, and I thank God for allowing us to come tonight, and He will bless us on the table. Worship begins with brokenness. You can't even worship God until you're broken yourself. That's the problem. Most of us think we're so high-minded that until we get a glimpse of who we really are, we can't even see who God is. You'll get that next week. And so I write about brokenness. The Encouragement came out of that. So there are 3 CDs here. The Encouragement is on this one. And the next broken one's here. But everyone said, this is the new one. You know, I didn't go to marketing school. You know, I set up. Can't eat this one, which is a short version, without you getting one. God bless us real good, okay? Do this for me, stand on your feet. Can we sing a little bit for you this morning?
Okay. I love
the spirit of the choir.
Yeah.
And I'm tired, so I need to really deputized all of you all to sing with me today. Now, this is what we want to do. How many of you had your first cup of coffee? We can go a little longer because you can miss the Redskins game, right? Came on at 9 o'clock or something. We catch you on NFL Network at night, so we might as well have a good time.
That's right.
You had your coffee, you got your caffeine. See,
like
praise
that.
Is good for you spiritually, it is also good for you physically.
Yes.
So I'm going to need you to move a little bit, and we're going to get the cardio in, because when the woman of God's going to preach, she wants us a little up. So it's my job today. I'm going to get you up, and then I'm going to set you up for worship. But if you do this, I know you're comfortable. Just get in the aisles a little bit, this one right there. And we're going to crank this track. Take it all the way to the top. And this is called Our God Can. If you're comfortable, take it all the way to the top. That's a good sound. I like that. Now look at someone say, Our God Can. Someone shout, Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How many of y'all believe that?
want to say, I'm encouraged, because I got case histories that God can work out. And see, you can't even sing that day. I've been working with singers for years. Years, 20 years, that's what I do. I'm a vocal teacher and arranger, and I've had singers singing that song, but you can't really sing that until you get some case histories with God. You lose some things, you go through something, then you really can look at someone in their eyes and say, listen, I'm telling you, it's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. Stay with God. He can work it out. That's why I saw this. I said, look, remember that. Look, remember Daniel. Look at someone and said, remember Daniel. If he did it for Daniel, won't he do it for you too? He doesn't want to be heard. Thank you so much. Thank you, Lord God. Amen. I love to worship. Anyone love to worship? This is what I want to do. Wrestling, not can you sing for me? See, wrestling's trying to get out of singing. He got the camera, so I won't call him. Y'all see what wrestling just did? Tomorrow, while I set this up, I want you to give one of those CDs to anyone that looks like they're supporting William Beck and the Friends. Come on, just walk out there and say, give one of the choir members behind you first. Give another one to someone on the audience. This poor guy, he did a new one to the pastor, though. We got here to the pastor. The pastor might help himself. Give it to the pastor first. Give the pastor one. Yes, sir. Y'all know where the marketing school, right? That's how you do it. I love worshiping because worship really responds to God. I heard the woman of God, she said that was Mary talking. And if you have a relationship with God, you know that worship is all about responding to Him. Mary folk, get that. You don't want to have a lover that won't respond to you. And you don't want to have a lover that's always taking but don't never get nothing back. Y'all get that next week. But when you're worshiping God, it's responding back to Him. Now, perhaps He has not done anything for anyone in here. But for those of you who He has done something for, I just want you to close your eyes and we want to worship Him and get out the way. We want to prepare the spirit in the house for the word to come for. I'm going to sing this two quick song that goes. I love this because it says, I am thine, O Lord, say.
To me.
best worship you can. You.